Hi, so this video is going to be about 3000 kilometers service of the Royal Enfield Himalayan. This is most suitable for people who have a Himalayan bike, and if not, it is not recommended, then just swipe to the next video. If you're new to this channel, you're welcome, and let's go to the video. So this is going to be a 15,000 kilometer service review. It has been around 2 years since I bought the bike. I have ridden only 15,000 kilometers, which is considerably less, because the first year I was like traveling much, I couldn't use the bike, and second year we started going for weekend rides, weekday rides, long, short, everything. So it's the most practical bike to be in this segment for this price range, and one of the good bike which has a wide service network all around the country. So in this 15,000 kilometers of ownership, I can give you two or three major issues which I faced the bike. So one is the clutch plates, which is like worn out when I came back from a 1200 kilometers bike ride. So I got it changed, and it was around 3000 or 4000 rupees for that. And the second most thing which I changed is the recent cone set bearing, which costed me around 1500 rupees with labor. So I had a bearing issue here, so it was like rusted and getting jammed. So when we park the bike, it is like so stiff, it doesn't go left or right even when it is in a center stand. So that issue got resolved when I checked it in the 15,000 kilometer service and got it replaced. So considering the total bill, I'll show you the bill in here and you can have a look. So this is the complete bill, like the four main parts which are taken are the chain lube and cleaner kit, which is the chain lubing and cleaning, which they have charged around 143 rupees without labor. And this is the semi-synthetic oil top up which is said due for the bike. The total required quantity is around 0.3 liters, so it is charged around 101. And dust seal steering ASI. So that is what the thing I said you, the bearings are gone, so they said they'll replace it. So the accessory around costs 68 rupees, and the total tapper roller bearing is the main part, which is on a costly end, around 966. So the total charge involved here is around 1280 rupees. And coming to the labor part, that is where it is so much costly. The consumables and charges for the service and the steering stem repairing and the scheduled 25,000 kilometers or 30 months. So mine is around 30 months, so it is called 15,000 kilometers. So the charge is 826 rupees for 15,000 kilometer service, and this is for the changing the bearing, labor for changing the bearing, and normal consumables, I don't know what they charge that for. So the total amount came up to 2690. Which is like considerably okay, not aggressive, considering I have around I have around 1400 rupees of bearing change charges involved in this. So if you remove the 1400, it will be around 1200 rupees max. So the total parts cost is 1280, and total labor cost is around 1410. So the labor cost is comparatively more than the cost of the parts, which is kind of a cheap compared to a bike of around 400cc engine. So I wouldn't say the Himalayan is a powerful bike. No, it is not. It is a linear power delivering machine, so it is fun in lower ends and not exciting in the higher ends, because it is a decent touring machine. Hope this content is helpful and useful to many of you people. And if you like the channel, do subscribe and connect to the channel. So I have added a recent accessory, a small top box.